And this is now a very simple example to start with. So I have some dates here, and then I have my four measures: quantity, costs, gross margin, revenues. All right. So this is, you know, a typical table, separate measures, separate data fields for and separate columns for all the KPIs, right? So the basic operation that allows you to build this KPI dimension is called unpivoting. All right, so if you're not familiar with that, let's just show this in Excel. So one way would be if you're in Excel and have a table like that, you just go to data and we'll click here from table range, which means that we will create a query that will actually turn those columns into one single column. All right. What I have now, after you click there, you actually get the tool called Power Query. Okay, so if you're not using this, if you're still, you know, maybe a beginner or simply not using Power Query, now is a good start to do that. what Power BI Power Query allows you is that, you know, you see your table and now you can apply many different types of transformations to this table. And the one that we actually need is called unpivot. So I could just select all the columns that I want to transform. And now by right clicking, you will find this option here, unpivot columns. All right. What happens is, as you see here, they are transposed and you will get one column, which is basically your KPIs like quantity and so on. So all of your columns will be consolidated in this one column. And then of course the value is here. So basically you just have two columns, your KPIs and the value. All right. So this was one way, actually an even better way. I just deleted this. So returning back to this, actually an even better way is to just select the column that you are not unpivoting, all right, this one. And now instead of unpivot, you select this option, unpivot other columns, all right? So this produces exactly the same result, but it's more safe because if you at a later point add another column, another KPI in your, you know, starting table here. So if you just add something else here, this transformation will automatically apply for additional columns and everything will work, right? So let's just close this. And yeah, see what you get here is a table in Excel, still in Excel right now, okay, with this structure, and this we would probably just call this KPI, right? And this is the basic operation, how you unpivot your KPIs, and now you will have them in this one data field, right? Which is the basic prerequisite of what we are doing. All right, the Power Query tool is actually the same in Power BI and in Excel. So basically the same thing that I did right now in Excel, you can do in Power BI. So you can just connect to this table, to this Excel table in Power BI, and then do the same thing with the Power Query in Power BI.